Hello everyone, I am Rohit and welcome to my YouTube channel AI Era. So guys, in this particular video, we are going to see another data visualization tool or another data visualization method to see or to visualize our data. This method called as a matrix plot. But before moving towards our Jupyter Notebook, I would like to tell you that in my channel, I will create a playlist. A playlist on a pandas library and a numpy library. Believe me guys, if you want to learn a data science or in future if you want to become a data science, then these both library are play a very important role to understanding a data. Therefore, if you new to my channel and if you see this video first time, then please access those library and don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel and press this bell icon. So without doing any delay, we just move into our Jupyter Notebook. So guys, here we are in our Jupyter Notebook. So in the previous video, we are playing with a library called a Seaborn and we're dealing or plotting with various kind of graphs such as scatter plot, bar plot, histogram, box and whiskers plot. We are gone through more detail in our previous video about the Seaborn library. So if you new on this channel and you see this video first time, then please access my previous video on my channel in my playlist. The all video of data visualization are in here in data visualization library. So we back to our Jupyter Notebook. So for those who are new to my channel, just a quick recap what is Seaborn and what kind of plot we are plot using a Seaborn library. So Seaborn is a Python data visualization library based on Matplotlib. It provides a high level of interface for drawing attractive and informative statistical graphs. Basically, using a Seaborn library, we can plot a scatter plot, bar plot, pairwise plot, histogram, and box and whiskers plot. So, dealing with or handling any kind of data, we required a data handling tool or data handling library. So, basically, a pandas library having such kind of capability to handle or read a data set. So, therefore, our first priority to start data visualization or to deal with any kind of problem is to visualize data. So therefore, in first cell or our first priority is to import a necessary library. So we import a necessary library by simply typing import pandas as pd, import seaborn as sns, import os. The os we import to change or select our current working directory. So here we set our current working directory or we set our working directory in E drive and in pandas folder. And we import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Because in previous we know that the Seaborn is based on matplotlib. So to execute this cell I have to press shift F. When this asterisk is get converted into number, the my cell is get executed. Okay, so my cell is get executed and shows the number 1. The next step I have to visualize some kind of data set. First I have to import a data set. So I can import a data set by simply saying df underscore tips dot load data set. In close parenthesis I have to mention my data set name tips. If you see my previous video, then you know that what is tips data set. Tips data set is basically a data set of hotels. This dataset contains number of customers visited to hotel, the time at which time they are probably coming at large number, the gender of their customer, tips received by waiters, etc. To get more information of our dataset, we import the dataset and check its first 5 rows and the feature of dataset. Therefore, we just check or write df underscore tips dot head and in close parenthesis. This command df underscore tips dot head command will give us the first 5 rows from my dataset. So I can press a shift enter to execute this cell. So you can see over here, it will show me first 5 rows of my dataset with the feature total bill, the bill paid by customer, tip, the received by waiter, the sex of visitor, smoker, whether the customer are smoker or not, the day at which they come at very large number. Probably in our previous video we see that by plotting bar plot at Saturday or Sunday, and on Saturday and Sunday the customer are visited in large number as compared to Thursday or Friday. So at what time they prefer to come at hotel for dinner, for brunch or for lunch, and the size. So to working with a matrix plot or to plotting a matrix plot, we have to find the correlation of that plot, because the correlation is nothing but our correlation matrix, and it gives us a correlation matrix. By using that correlation matrix we plot our correlation graph of correlation plot. So you can see over here, when I told or when I tell a matrix, then the matrix is basically generated by a number. It does not contain a categorical value such as sex, smoker, day and time. So it generates correlation matrix of only three features, that is total bill, tip and a size. So I can press a shift enter to generate my correlation matrix. So you can see over here, it will generate my correlation matrix, and the next step is to visualize our data set in a matrix plot. So plotting a matrix plot, I have to simply write sns.heatmap. That sns.heatmap, this command will help me to plot my matrix plot, and in close parenthesis I have to mention my correlation matrix. Then I have to mention the visualization type, that is CMAP, the color and how it's look. That there are various kind of types, so I can select a full form and I can select annotation is equal to true. So we can play around it and see what happens if we change this feature. To plot this I can press and, or to execute this cell I can press and shift enter. So after pressing shift enter you can see over here, according to your correlation matrix it will plot a graph. And if I change this CMAP or delete this CMAP, and I can press a shift enter, then by default it will generate our matrix plot as you can see over here. And if I delete this annotation from here, then probably you can see a number represented by every color. So if I just print or just visualize only my value in matrix plot and then press a shift enter, then you can see over it, it will give me various color, and I can have to visualize or get more information about this color from here, about this line. To better, I can keep that annotation is equal to true. So this is all about the matrix plot. To get more intuition about this graph, we can take another example, and we can take another data set called flight data set. So the in our first cell we have to simply import our data set by saying sns.load data set. In close parenthesis we have to mention our name of my data set, and we can visualize our data set by simply saying dataset.head. Here my data set is mentioned by df_flight. So you can see a first 5 rows of my data set, and here my feature are such kind of year, month and passenger. So I can correlate, or I can generate a correlation matrix from my data set. Here I can we cannot find a correlation from this month feature because this is a categorical feature. So I can here we can get a correlation matrix from only two features, that is year and passenger. So we can press a shift, so I can press a shift enter to get a correlation matrix. So here you can see it will show me a correlation matrix over here. But there is another method to find out a correlation matrix, because these two feature will not give me much more detail about my data set. So I can use a pivot command, and with in pivot feature on it or in pivot function I will have to mention the index, that is month, columns, years and values passenger. So it will give me another correlation matrix, and you can see over here it will shows me in January and in 1994 how many passenger are traveled by air, and in from 1949 to 1960 it will, the graph or the number shows it's still increasing. So we can create by using a pivot command a second correlation matrix, and we use this correlation matrix to generate our matrix plot. So by simply saying csns.heatmap and in close parenthesis we have to mention our matrix plot and the type or how we want to visualize our graph. That is, therefore we have to mention cmap is equal to a full plot, and I can press a shift enter. So you can see over here the matrix plot representation, it's look like over here. So this is enough for today's video. If you like this video, please like this, share with your friend, and do subscribe my YouTube channel, that is AI Era. And don't forget to press the bell icon and never miss any update. Thank you, one and all.